Right. So, what is this difference? Why is it that the sun literally strengthens us? But it kills human beings. DEA. What makes us more athletic than human beings? DEA. They can't explain shit else to you. They can't. Go talk to any doctor. They're not going to speak the esoteric facts. So they'll say, he trained. No, bro. We don't be trained in shit. We like that. Like, go to any hood in America, you're going to find 100 niggas that could jump out the gym. You feel me? 100 more black people, Latino people that will outrun any track star. What are you talking about? You see what I'm saying? Like, we just naturally like that. We naturally like that. This shit natural. I tumble, I ran track, I play, but I'm athletic as hell. Like, it's natural. We ain't got to do none of that. Well, I ain't worked out in months. I'm still cut the fuck up. See what I'm saying? Like, if a person don't know me, if you know me, you're like, yeah, God, it worked out a minute. But if you don't know me, you're going to be like, damn, what's your workout plan? Because some of y'all be like that. Like, well, I ain't worked out in a minute. You hear me? I ain't worked out in a minute. I've been super slacking. You know what I'm saying? But we, the genetics. It's a genetic thing. And sometimes human beings, y'all even know it's genetics. I've heard human beings say it. Genetics. Y'all didn't say it now. Okay, so we're talking about genetics now. Okay, so what are these genetics that's different? Let's put a title on it. Let's title this shit. Let's just stop saying it's genetics. See what I'm saying? Let's stop saying it's genetics. What are the specific genetics that's doing this? See what I'm saying? What's the name of the genetics that is responsible for this major difference? Why the fuck are our skin so dark? All this neuromelanin and carbon. Dark matter energy. At the highest state, this is dark matter energy. Then it descends, and as it falls in dimensions, remember, four phases of matter. Solids, liquids, gases, plasma, energy. We descend from the astral realms down here. So as we descend, we have to have bodies that we can take on. So all that dark matter manifest in this physical reality, right? As carbon and neuromelanin. Not melanin, neuromelanin. 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 Neuro. Because see, niggas be still saying melanin. Neuromelanin. Melanin, right? This is neuromelanin, not melanin, okay? Human beings have melanin, okay? Neuromelanin, neuromelanin, and carbon, which has manifested in a physical state. So it's in a lower density, so it manifests as this carbon in neuromelanin. But if you catch us vibrating in the astral realms, it's just pure dark matter energy. Same thing. But as you go through different vibrations, plasma realm, gas, liquid, solids, because you're descending into this material realm. You descend, you come down. You come down here. You get what I'm saying? Your soul and spirit descends. So you're coming from higher states of consciousness just to have this earthly experience. Okay? Let me rewind that. You descend from higher realms, OK? Okay, so you land, you come down. No, because you got to get it. You come down here. You came down here into a lower vibration to have this earthly, this material. This is all material, material experience. Okay, you had to lower your vibration just to get here. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, just to get here. Okay, so that's a cosmic thing. If you don't have neuromelanin and carbon, that means you're not a dark matter energy being. Now, what's dark matter energy? This is the nine ether. Okay, so when we say nine ether, now we're talking genetics. Okay, so this is what makes us nine ether beings. All this stardust, all this neuromelanin, all this carbon that's descended from the astral planes. This is energy. So this is a powerful thing, Negro. You see what I'm saying? This is powerful. Why do you think when they used to kill certain versions of us, let's use Nat Turner, they would skin, they would fillet us. They would fillet us. Keep your body parts, keep your genitals, keep your heart, keep this, keep the ether. Okay, this is a very powerful thing. This is a weapon. You're a weapon. You're a whole weapon. Okay, but why don't human beings have that? Why is it that when black people and Latino people get in the sun, we charge up? That's genetics. Okay, so these genetics is DEA. DEA. When you go past neuromelanin, and you talk about dark matter energy was formed in nine ethers. So when you're talking, when you're dealing with the nine, these are the most powerful beings in the cosmos. Any beings that's in the nine ethers or the ninth universe, right? These are the most powerful beings throughout the entire multiverse. Like, that's a fact, right? Because of how powerful the celestial rays are around this, that had to gather together to create this dark matter energy. Okay, remember, this dark matter energy is a combination of divine feminine energy mixed with divine masculine energy in its essence. That's what dark matter energy is. Okay, I'll repeat that. Remember, dark matter energy is divine feminine energy combined with divine masculine energy at its presence, right? And at its full, see, that's dark matter energy. Now, we are full of that. So we are so radiant. We are radiant beings that the sun actually empowers us. The sun should kill us too. The sun is an actual solar weapon. We shouldn't even be able to take that sun, y'all. You see what I'm saying? It's a lot of beings. It's a lot of beings, y'all. It's a lot of beings. It's a whole lot of beings on different planets that cannot take the sun at all. The Pleiadians can't take the sun. There are entire different, and the Pleiadian race is an advanced extraterrestrial race that look just like human beings, and they can't take the sun. The reptilians, powerful as fuck, and they can't take the sun. That's why they got to shapeshift into human beings. And then they still spend most of their time living in caves and underground. The reptilian race, they can't take the sun. See what I'm saying? The insectoids, that's an extraterrestrial race. They're like tall ass praying mantis. The insectoids, it's an actual extraterrestrial race. They can't take the sun either. You feel me? The grays, the Zeta grays, which is when you think of alien, you think of a Zeta gray because they always showed us Zeta grays, right? They had us thinking the Zeta grays were the only aliens, right? They never went into the different species and all of that, right? Because they didn't want us to know anything about the cosmos, right? That emoji right there that just got posted of an alien. Those are how the Zeta grays look. Those are the Zeta grays. The Zeta grays, they one of the most intelligent species throughout the whole multiverse. And they ass can't even take the sun. That's why they got on a gray jumpsuit. That when you see the alien, the gray face with the black eyes, that's an actual space suit. They don't look like that. They have regular eyes like us under those lids. Those black lids that open up, they have regular eyes under there. Those are glasses. And their skin, do you think that's their skin? That's a suit. They can come out of that. They look completely different. No different than when they showed you an astronaut in that big goofy ass suit with that big ass bow fishbowl. He ain't went to no moon, but they got us thinking that, right? So they got him in this big ass suit, fishbowl helping on. He moving like he really in water, but they got you thinking he floating and shit like one small step for man. They underwater like a motherfucker. Like y'all in the whole swimming pool in Hollywood and Cali when they shot that shit. One small step for man, he floating. You think, right? Same thing. Like they can't take our atmosphere. So that's an actual suit that they be having on. But you think that's how they look. That's a suit. It's a space suit. You know what I'm saying? No lie, right? And they can't take the sun, nigga. You see what I'm saying? Don't think this sun is something that everybody can take in this multiverse. I'm just using them as an example. It's many more beings that cannot take the sun. We literally channel the frequency of the sun. We give life to the sun. Like, you have to understand the sun is an actual weapon. It's an actual weapon. That's why they can't let it shine 24 motherfucking 7. That's the whole reason that they created clouds. Let's not forget why the clouds were created. The clouds were created to literally block out the sun. No other reason. The clouds wasn't created just roll by. It wasn't no clouds here originally. Nigga, we never had a cloud in the sky. We never had a cloud in the sky before these beings landed on our planet and invaded us. We ain't have no motherfucking clouds, y'all. Nigga, we ain't have no clouds. It was two big ass suns in the sky shining 24/7. It was no nighttime, none of that here. You feel me? The whole purpose of clouds is to block out the sun, to stop your cosmic connection, all these divine 93 beings, connection to the sun as much as possible. All right? So we have to ask ourselves. Self, why is it that black people have this cosmic connection to the sun and the planet? But if I'm a human being and I go sit in the sun, it starts to kill me. It starts to cook my skin. It starts to eat at me. I literally need to put suntan lotion on. I need an ointment to be able to absorb any, because I can't absorb those cosmic rays, right? But why though? See, why can't you absorb those cosmic rays? The animals can, the plants can, right? So if I'm a human being, I'm asking myself, why? You know, black people can't be human beings. We can't be the same. Even if I'm a human being, I'm thinking like that, like there's no way. Okay, let's look at little shit. We have to use little things, y'all, that happens in everyday society. Okay, so let's talk about lice. Human beings get lice like it ain't nothing. But gods and goddesses, or Anunnaki gods and goddesses, the Anunnaki, the descendants of the Anunnaki, right? If you want to call us that, or the Anunnaki, because this is really what we are. The Anunnaki, right? The children of the Anunnaki, however you want to call it, right? They don't experience that. And it's all based around because human beings have DNA. Okay? So, human beings, you have DNA. Okay? DNA. Okay? So, let's look at it. You have DNA. Let me show you what DNA look like. This is DNA. Okay, human beings, you have DNA. So, you see this? DNA. This is DNA, all right? Now, this is called a double helix. This is called a double helix, okay? You have two helixes. One, two, a double helix. Now, because you have DNA, all right, you only have one series. And if you are mixed, some of you can, it's between 1 to 3 series of this. Of this so-called DNA. Okay? These double helixes are actually cells. All right? So, as a human being, you only have one series of this or three. So that means that you have one of these or three of these. So imagine three of these. 1, 2, 3. If you are a 6 ether being, which means human being, all right, you have DNA. Now, because you have DNA, this is the true reason why you can't channel the frequency of the sun, okay? Because you have DNA, all right? You have DNA. So that's one of these. You only have one of these, okay? You have one. Now, what they don't tell people, okay, about this genetically, all right, genetically is this link right here. This is a hydrogen link. Now, human beings, you were replicated from us, all right? Hold on, I'm gonna finish to talk about it. But human beings, you were replicated from us, okay? So by you being replicated from us, you have a lot of the same things we have, like, okay, two eyes, for example, a nose, a mouth, two hands with five fingers, chest or breast, penis, two legs, 2 feet, right? That's the God physique. Arm, leg, arm, head, okay? That's God in manifestation, okay? This is why the Muslims, because they infiltrated Islam. Islam was an esoteric teaching. Islam itself stands for I, Self, Lord, and Master. But the oppressors infiltrated all forms of information, and they didn't flip Islam back a whole different way. Okay? So, you only have, yeah, because the body, arm, leg, arm, head, which is Allah. Because man, or the black/Latino man and woman, is God in manifestation. Without the physical body, it's black matter, dark matter energy. Still creative and doing what we do in the cosmos and the astral realms. But when we descend into this physical state, we are still with that same God, but in manifestation. So this is what Allah esoterically, anciently meant. Arm, leg, arm, head. That's the body of what? This physique. And Allah is considered who in Islam? God, right? Allah is the name of God, okay? So, human beings, you were made in our image by Satan. Yaqub, Prometheus, Jacob in the Bible. That's why all of these characters I'm naming, they got that same story of tampering with some form of genetics to create a new species. Go read about them. Go read about Jacob in the Bible. Which is just Yaqub, but with a J in front. And how he separated the sheep, he separated the flocks. They're talking about the genetics. Zeus, that's what Zeus did. He separated the genetics. That's what Yaqub did. He separated the brown gene from the black gene to create a whole new species. That's what Prometheus did. In the beginning, Prometheus created who? Mankind. That's what they tell you about Prometheus' story. Because human beings, you are mankind. You are a kind of man made in the likeness of the gods. That's why in the Bible, your Bible, which is the beginning of your creation story as a human being, it clearly says, then we said, let us make man in our image. Because that was what Zeus said. Let us. Who the fuck is us? That means plural. That's plural. More than one. Right? We never caught that in religion. But it was said in the Bible, in Genesis. Let us make man in our image. The us was Zeus with the other fallen gods in the lab creating the human beings. In us, in our image. You were made in our image. This is where you get all your shit from. Your arm, leg, leg, arm, head. See? But he was only, Zeus was only able to give you the physical aspect of us. A lot of the genetic inner workings, he couldn't replicate that. And that's the only difference between a human being and a god. We both look alike. You see? So we can walk amongst each other and they lied about history, so we think we all one human race. Because we look alike. But internally, we have two completely different inner workings, two completely different genetics, with completely different species. We not from here neither. Human beings, you're not from here, but you were created somewhere else. And that's okay. And then you came here. But us?